Thanks, everyone. Please allow me to introduce myself. My name is Henry, partnering with Ready for Life, and it's my pleasure to introduce the organization as well as activities and our participation within the project with all of you. Of course, Ready for Life, we are based in South Africa. The picture that you see there was actually taken on the 10th anniversary celebrations with our building at the background. Ready for Life extensively used the experience of international students as well as volunteers, which we would then actually link to specific projects in schools or in our disadvantaged communities. There you can also see a nice picture of Port Elizabeth, at least our World Cup 2010 stadium also there, the North End Lake. We also have on the left-hand side our harbor, but more in the middle, the townships, and that is our focus area to target the disadvantaged community as well as to uplift them. Some of the projects that we were busy with, for example, our smart city project in the Nelson Mandela Bay region. We also focus on 4IR essential computer literacy skills. We also partner quite a lot with incubators, ICT incubators like the iHub, like Propeller. And we would like to focus more on the pre-incubation phase before these entrepreneurs enter the incubation. And of course, we extensively do ICT support for township schools by maintaining, refurbishing their computer labs also. Then at the bottom, you see some of our volunteers in action. Another successful program was Swim Safe, where we actually teach the youngsters, the township youngsters, how to swim and also how to enjoy our beaches safely. When it comes to our digital literacy frameworks, because South Africa don't have its own framework, we actually look at international frameworks like the UNESCO one, the European one, the DigiCom 2.1, as well as even the United Kingdom standards. And we've decided to use DigiCom 2.1 as a reference model, as a framework, because it's already synthesized with other major digital literacy frameworks. It's very extensive, long consultation development process. We are quite happy with that. And it also represents a comprehensive view of all the different competences areas that we actually need. Of course, there's a lot of content available, and that is just a picture of the material that we're also currently using. And then, of course, as part of Digital Generation Youth, we also use open badges. We're also part of the Cities of Learning platform. And we are quite happy to partner all these esteemed cities. Of course, on the right-hand side, you will see Eastern Cape Regions of Learning. And our wish is also for this platform, of course, to grow more. This is just a screenshot of our website, the Eastern Cape Regions of Learning. You can see Port Elizabeth on bottom right-hand corner there. So it's quite a large region to actually to cover. But for now, our focus, of course, is only Port Elizabeth. And Sandra will still remember we did about two activities in Jeffreys Bay. When it comes to best practices, what we normally do is to refer all our clients or whoever we interact with our Regions of Learning platform, our Badgecraft platform. And also, there's also in this specific screen, you can see there's also some efficient rules in developing or executing digital badges initiatives. Just some examples. So yes, that is our presentation for now. Thank you.